Morency Unfiltered on the Fantasy Sports Network continues. Let's bring in our AFL tipster, Mick Aussie from MickAussie.com. Mick, it's always a pleasure. How you doing?
Yeah, good, mate. And, yeah, the Cats beat the Crows last night in what was touted to be the game of the round. So the Cats are on fire, mate. Early premiership chance, those Geelong Cats.
Yeah, the Geelong Cats are really, really upsetting me, Mick. They've only lost one game all year, the game that I bet on them. It was week two. It's week two. I went against them. Who'd they beat? They won the first game of the year against Hawthorne. Then they lost on the road to Great Western Sydney. And they haven't lost since. Unbelievable, yeah. 98-72 win. Low-scoring game. Crows could only put 72 up, Mick.
Yeah, well, they're a good side, Cats. And it was the return of Patrick Dangerfield to Adelaide. But silly me, I had a few beers last week and had a bet with Jennifer. So another thing, don't bet when you're having beers, mate, because I shouldn't have bet that.
When aren't you having beers, Mick? When aren't you having beers, huh? All right, so, Essendon and North Melbourne playing as we speak. Hawthorne and Fremantle playing as we speak as well. So let's get into some of the games that... the people can still get their action in on. Let's take a look. Great Western Sydney, -54.5 against Gold Coast, Mick.
Yeah, that's a fair spread. They're on fire. They're a great team. They're a big chance to finish top four. I pick them to win. Pretty sure they'll win, but I don't think they'll cover. I think they'll win by like 45, so probably go the plus on the Suns. But yeah, Giants are on fire, going along very nicely.
That's a lot of points, but we got burnt last week taking the 72. We ended up losing by, 81 with the Bombers. We'll get to that in a couple of moments' time. All right, it is a high number. All right, Brisbane and Collingwood here. What do you think of this one?
Oh, that's the Magpies are terrible.
Is like for NFL fans, this is like sort of, this is the Cleveland Browns versus the, the Jacksonville Jags. This is like the Jags-Titans Thursday night game. Yeah, this is a horrible game, man. Brisbane and Collingwood.
Yeah, it's a horrible game, Gabe, but the Collingwood Magpies have probably the biggest supporter base in Australia. Like a Melbourne team, they're black and white. You either love or hate them. The former star, Nathan Buckley, is coaching them, and his job is on the line. So they need to win. But I think the Lions will win. It's up there in Brisbane, and the Magpies have been terrible. So take the Lions to win and probably to cover.
Yeah, they're -6.5 in this game. All right, we got Richmond and Sydney, the Swans. Swans are -22.5 point favorites.
Well, they're on fire. They're the ones that absolutely smashed Essendon last week and blew that big spread for us. So, take the Swans to win. And probably cover. I think they'll win by like 30 or something. The Tigers have lost their skipper, Trent Kotchkin. He's a good player. So even though it's in Melbourne where the Tigers are from and the Swans got to travel down there, it's not that far. So take the Swans to win and to cover.
All right, let's talk about Carlton and Port Adelaide. Port Adelaide, -11.5, the Power, total 190.5.
Yeah, that's an interesting one, mate, because the Carlton Blues, have surprised of late, and they're playing quite well. And then also, the Port Adelaide Power, the Pacmeers, they're on fire lately. They've hit form, so I think the power should win that one. And again, I'd like them to cover. They're a team I don't really like, but they're doing quite well lately.
You're not a fan of the Paps, huh?
Well, they're my opposition, mate. I grew up and played in Adelaide, so I used to play against Port Adelaide Magpies. So that's how the Power came to be. They formed from the SANFL Port Adelaide Magpies.
So is there like junior teams? So it's like the junior Crows and the junior Papsmears and stuff, like growing up too?
No, they Port Adelaide did, yeah, under 17, under 19s, reserves, and then the league in the SANFL. But now the Power and the Crows do have a second team, but that's only just formed in the last couple of years. So The AFL formed about 20 years ago, Gabe. Before that, it was Victoria, South Australia and Perth were the top three leagues, you see.
All right, so 11.5. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to lay the 11.5 in this game as well. Ever since they got blown out in a couple of weeks in a row, remember? They got smashed by 50 or whatever. Their coach was freaking out. Seems like Port Adelaide, like you said, they're hitting their stride right now. They're coming together.
Yeah, I agree.
All right, Melbourne and the Western Bulldogs. Western Bulldogs, -13.5 point favorites against Melbourne.
Oh, this could be an upset. The Demons are one of those teams that are up and down, but they're playing well. My informant back in Australia, he reckons that could be a dicey one. That said, I think the Bulldogs will win and probably cover. They beat the Crows in Melbourne last week. They're a good team. They're a young team. So, again, probably take the Bulldogs to cover on that one, but that could be an upset.
All right, and we'll wrap it up with West Coast. The Eagles, West Coast Eagles, -43.5 point favorites against St. Kilda.
Yeah, definitely like them to win. But, again, the Saints are a bit like the Demons. They're up and down. They're on the improve. It's over there in Perth. So take the Eagles to win. Probably not to cover, but you never know, Dicey, mate, as you can tell.
It's a tough week this week. There's a lot of big numbers, and, yeah, they're tough. So what would the best bet, what's the tipsters, Mitch Senior's best bet of the week?
I would go something like this, Gabe. I would take four or five teams to win and put them all together. What do you call that? Not a trifecta, it's a three. So put four or five teams together for the win, right? And go for the win, go Eagles, Swans, Sydney Giants, Lions, and Eagles. No, I already said that. Something like that power. So put four or five teams to win together and maybe you win some decent money, something like that. Because, yeah, the spreads are... Spread's a bit tricky this week.
Well, even Port Adelaide and Sydney. Although, I'll tell you what, the Sydney Swans screwed me last. Was it the Swans that screwed me? Yeah, I think it was, actually. -1. No, it was Gold Coast. Sorry, it was Gold Coast and Sydney. Yeah, I lied. I'm an idiot. I had Gold Coast. So it was Port Adelaide and Sydney. So a power swan, the power swan. Is +103. That's not a bad parlay, Mick. Yeah, and in North America, we call it a parlay, mate.
Yeah, parlays too, though, isn't it? Yeah, I love going the trifecta, like horse racing, the three bets at once. I kind of like that.
All right. So, hey, before we wrap it up, I see that it's a big UFC card this week for Brazil, Mick. It's going to be some great stuff. Heavyweight championship fight between Miosic and Fabricio Verdum. But you know that Frank Mir, of course, UFC legend, multiple two-time Hall of heavyweight champion, future Hall of Famer and all that. Friend of the program, too. Me and Mir go way back. Of course, Mir tested positive, but they really weren't sure what he tested positive for. And he's blaming your country, Mick. He's saying that he ate some kangaroo meat.
Can you believe that? I mean, I've got to hand it to him for being very creative and realizing that a lot of Americans would probably say, well, that might sound a bit reasonable, but no way. And that's why I reckon the North Melbourne Kangaroos are probably smashing the Bombers right now because they're so upset. Blame the Kangaroos, not happy, mate. They're upset. They're getting blamed and blamed for...
Well, you know, Mick, I don't know if you've seen, though, the NFL sent out a warning to their players telling them, do not eat any steaks from Mexico. You're going to test positive for a banned stimulant. Now, I get that we don't want, like, a total steroid society, but if it's to the point where you know a dude ate it from a steak, then what are we arguing for? Oh, what, he went to Mexico to eat a steak to cheat the system? Like, come on, man. If Frank Mir ate some kangaroo meat, it is what it is, but I don't want to eat a kangaroo. I look at a kangaroo like a little Easter bunny. And my boy Feinberg looks like, you'll eat anything. You eating kangaroos? Yeah, he's like, no, they're cute. Come on, they're hopping around. But as an Australian, you know, you locals, you guys hate kangaroos, right?
Mate, you know what? We up in the north, yeah, where they eat lots of nice green grass. I ate a kangaroo burger up near Darwin probably 25 years ago. Tasted good. Now they're actually breeding kangaroos for consumption. So even in South Australia, in the country, in Morgan, a local pub, I was up there a couple of years ago. And kangaroo was on the menu, so they're breeding kangaroos.
That's not cool, man. That's not cool. So what's the deal, though? Are, like, kangaroos, is it true? Like, people, everyone, you know, the stereotype, everyone thinks everyone's walking around drinking Foster's, talking like Crocodile Dundee, and there's kangaroos hopping around everywhere. Like, people think there's, like, kangaroos hopping around in, like, Sydney and Melbourne downtown.
Well, mate, you've always gone hardcore, and I'm going to go hardcore right now for all the Americans and Canadians listening. There's millions of kangaroos in the outback of Australia, and they eat the grass. They eat the farmer's grass, so they shoot a lot of kangaroos. Just like in Crocodile Dundee, you go roo shooting. So, no, it's a fallacy. Oh, yeah, they look cute in the zoos and stuff. It's all a marketing campaign. They eat the sheep and the cattle's feed. So, yes, they're a bit of a pain in the ass, mate. But if you hit one on the highway when you're driving along, they will absolutely mess up your car. And we have what's called roo bars. So you have a big bar across the front of your car to protect your car when you
hit it. Yeah, it's like moose in Canada, right? You don't want to hit a moose. That's for sure. All right. I'm sure the people from PETA really love this segment. Hey, I love kangaroos. It is what it is. Mick, it's always a pleasure. Thanks.
All right, and yeah, we probably did upset Pamela Anderson at PETA, but yeah, there's some truth in Frank Mir. These athletes, they do have to watch what they eat. There's no doubt about that. But picking on a kangaroo, I don't like that one, Gabe. See you later.
Mick Ossie joining us. Oh, it's always a pleasure breaking it down with Mick Ossie. We'll come back with a final segment of the week.